What if you could cut your visceral fat in half without dieting, without exercising more, without any meds, no side effects, and you could do it fast? Sounds like influencer clickbait, right? Well, before you click the thumbs down and go back to watching prank videos, a recent double-blind randomized control trial showed this can be done. Scientists took 200 people with NAFLD, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and they split them randomly. Half were given resistant starch. The other half were given the same amount of calories from regular starch. After 4 months of this intervention, they measured their liver fat again. In the folks getting the regular starch, there was no significant change. But the group getting resistant starch cut their liver fat in half, from 25% down to 13%. And they got these starches in a powdered form, and they looked the same. They were packaged the same, not labeled. So this is a blinded trial. The participants didn't know which one they were getting. And even the investigators that were in direct contact with the participants, they didn't know who was in which group. So it's double blinded. And the regular starch works almost as a placebo. So it's a very good experimental design. The group getting the resistant starch also saw a drop in their overall body size measurements. Body weight, waist circumference, body fat percentage, everything came down. But even after adjusting for the weight loss, they still saw a significant reduction in liver fat. So it wasn't all explained by weight loss. So this is saying that the resistant starch is disproportionately affecting liver fat, visceral fat. The folks on the resistant starch also saw an improvement of their liver enzymes. That makes sense. Those are usually elevated in people with fatty liver, and they come back down when people lose some of that liver fat, triglycerides, LDL cholesterol, some inflammatory markers, HOMA-IR, which is a measure of insulin resistance, fasting insulin, and blood pressure. All were improved. These are kind of mind-blowing results just by adding some resistant starch to a diet. Now, how would resistant starch affect liver fat? It might be through the microbiome. So resistant starch is a type of carbohydrate that is not broken down, it's not digested in the small intestine. It persists all the way to the large intestine, where our microbiome can then break it down and produce short-chain fatty acids. And in fact, they saw that the folks getting resistant starch, they had changes to their microbiome. Species that are normally associated to fatty liver, people with fatty liver have more of these species, like, for example, the species of bacteria called Bacteroides stercoris. They were reduced. These people getting the resistant starch had a lower level of these bacteria. So maybe these bacteria are contributing to liver fat, to visceral fat accumulation, and reducing the level of these bacteria helps. In order to test if it really is cause and effect, they changed the microbiome of mice. So they took mice with fatty liver. You give the mice a very fatty diet. They develop fatty liver. Then you wipe out their microbiome by giving them antibiotics. And then you give them a fecal transplant. You basically take a stool sample from the human participants getting the resistant starch, and you implant that into the mice. So you're transplanting the microbiome of these participants into these mice. Bottom line, these mice receiving the fecal transplant, they saw a reduction of their body weight, their liver fat, their insulin resistance, their inflammatory markers, everything got better. And even within the liver, genes that turn on fat production, those were reduced, and genes that break down fat, those were increased in these mice. So this supports the idea that the microbiome might be causing some of these metabolic changes and affecting liver fat. Now, one question that remains from this trial is the source of resistant starch, because they used a powder where the resistant starch actually comes from corn. So it's a powdered resistant starch product. And they actually don't explain exactly how the participants consumed these powders, which is unfortunate. Usually they're consumed by mixing the powder in water and drinking it or sprinkling it over foods. So the obvious question here is, can you get the same results from foods that naturally contain resistant starch? Obviously, this trial doesn't prove that, and the amount that they gave participants was pretty high, 40 grams of resistant starch daily, which is substantial if you were going to get it from food. For example, one serving of beans has around 5 grams of resistant starch, give or take. Fava beans are some of the highest, and they have between 7 and 12 grams per serving. Rolled oats have about 7 grams per serving. So it is possible to get 40 grams of resistant starch per day from foods if the diet is put together pretty carefully and targeting specific foods. But most people are certainly not getting that, definitely not in the West. Also, is this a one-off? In science, we always want to see confirmation, right? With one study, we're always careful. So there is another randomized trial, similar design, gave them the same powdered resistant starch product, same dose, and they also saw a reduction of visceral fat. And that trial is smaller, fewer people. And there are some trials that don't see this effect, no reduction of visceral fat. Now, this might come down to the dose. As I looked at all these trials, these two that worked, they gave them this high dose that we talked about, 40 grams of resistant starch daily. Trials that give a lower dose, usually a third to half of the amount of the product, those tend to not work. So we got some really exciting results with this form of resistant starch. It will be interesting in the future to see if we can replicate this with whole foods. For a lot more on losing visceral fat, including the best workouts, check out this previous video, and I'll see you in there.